Yeah, Darshan, you are. I am not going to ask you which school you are from. But unfortunately, what happened is I came cricket field. I become the opening batsman. So you want to be the opening bowler or batsman? You have to tell me.
Batsman.
You want to be batsman. So you want to score a century.
Okay. How do you feel being a designer in a company? I'm sure you know the age of your company. How old are they?
120 years young, we call. We don't call it old, I think we are young.
1897 they started. And I don't know what is our age. Sudhir was supposed to ask me my age. So I'm just 17. 17. So I worked in a company which is 1880. That is closed, but Godrej is still going. I had a look of your work. Tell me something more about your work and your journey as a designer, what you feel.
As you said, you know, when I started, there was a lot of responsibility as a designer for me because it's a company which started with a vision of, you know, being part of the whole independence at that time and how they can industrialize and make products for Swadesh. There's so much rich history and innovation in the company that when I joined in, the time had changed completely. The TG was, the target user was different, much younger, exposed to different things. And there was a time where we needed to be relevant again for a different audience in the same country who has developed so well and looking at different heights at that time. So the purpose remained the same, but the situation and context changed, your consumer and the user changed, their expectations and the aspirations had changed. It was literally like still being rooted to the, you know, promise of what Godrej wanted to do for our country. How can we take the same spirit when it started during the independence, you know, the first vegetable soap or the first hair dye, which was packed 3 gram pouch for masses to use. And we're literally heart of Kirana store. How can I again be relevant to this user who's looking to grow every day in their lives? And I belong to a small town, as I told you, right? And when I was in a small town, I didn't wanted a mitti ka piggy bank or some craft or rangoli. I wanted my father to go to Ahmedabad and bring some fancy toys for me, right? And that doesn't mean that I'm not rooted or there is no cultural aspect to it, but it's what culture means at that time is very different. So we literally had to revisit the meaning of what Godrej can mean to today's generation, and how can we be part of that journey. At the same time, what was interesting that even Godrej was in the transition in terms of leadership when, you know, Mr. Adi Godrej was the chairperson, which is led it very well, and now the new generation coming in. How can we showcase that Godrej is changing and transforming, and you know, these are the values we stand for. So there was a lot of responsibility as a designer. It was not about making fancy packaging or using design as a tool to make things look beautiful, but literally recraft the purpose and the meaning and take it forward ahead. So that's been. You know, we have a very nice write-up from Gandhi actually for Godrej when Godrej innovated first vegetable soap.
From a small town.
Yeah.
Say,
yes.
Yeah.
I always forget where I thought that I'm. How does it feel to come from such a small town, as you're saying, and very proudly you said that I went to local school, and then you came from there little further to Anand, and then little further to NID, and little further to Godrej. Now you want to talk about the Gandhi, how Gandhi became Godrej, because you also said Swadeshi.
Yeah.
But do you know what is Godrej mean to the world?
Yeah, so, you know, Godrej was probably has always been a benchmark. I mean, the first safe we made, the locks, refrigerators, etc. We needed to...
I don't think they made refrigerators at that time.
Yeah, it was locks and the safe. At that time, we made ballot boxes for the the election. And that was the only product which survived the massive fire which happened during that time. And that's a benchmark of quality, and that's something, again, whether it's FMCG where I work today, or whether it's furniture, whether it's locks, something which remains very, very integral part of the company is quality and trust. And people trust Godrej for its quality and the value it gives at the price, right? So as designers, you know, you can always make things look more exclusive, international fashion. You can bring a lot of those nuances, but how can you make consumer feel great about willingness to pay? So if at 5 rupees, if I can create that disproportionate delight, is actually Gandhi and it's actually Godrej in a way. So how can, you know, somewhere that purpose come, kind of keeps alive the way it looks, the way it feels, the aesthetics change because of that's how consumers are going to look at it. But somewhere it all comes together.
1904, when the first ballot box was given to India.
Yeah.
And today you are making some other product. How do you relate this to different products? You are making mostly soap,
hair colors.
Hair color.
Yeah.
Then I think Rasna even used to market.
Yeah.
Because it's made in the name of Godrej. And now, because most, let's say I was in textile company and it was a complete cycle, you know, textile to chemicals to plastic. But from ballot box or from lock, the safety, are you trying to make the safety look for your health product, soap and hair color? Hair color is something is not, I would not like even if they give me a couple of crores to color my hair. No, I would not. So the point is, how do you brand your company? Well, I have seen some of your product. I don't use most of them. But how do you say the Godrej is hair dye or Godrej is, you know, hand wash? Plus, there is something, you know, the key, the lock, the safety. Now, how as a designer, because you came from a school where there is a, you know, some kind of brand making the whole thing.
Yeah.
You know, we are in design.
No, I get, yeah.
Because product is not, also you have furniture.
Hmm.
You know, and how do you really make, as a designer, make that triangle from lifestyle to cosmetic, two locks. Can you find something that you could do for the commonality with this whole thing?
Yeah, so just to establish that I work for Godrej Consumer Products, which is into household personal care and home care segments. And we have brands across hair care, soaps, air fresheners, insecticides, laundry care. While that all sounds, you know, something we interact with every day, and as you say, there are other companies as well. It's in the DNA of Godrej, right? We are in NID. We say we are NIDians. When you go to Godrej, it's a way of design thinking process. First step is to understand which organization you're working in and what it means, and when you start designing some of those solutions for. But coming back to FMCG. It is something, just to put some statistics, every rural household, 2 out of 4 households in rural use hair color, and 3 out of 4 households in urban use hair color. The other statistic is 1 out of every 3 households in rural uses insecticides, while every 3 out of 4 households uses insecticides in urban. These are products which are always in and around us. It's basically making kirana stores, making consumers make good choices and find meaningful, purposeful products in really, really busy kirana stores. And how, as with Godrej's principle, how can you still stand out and what do you mean to them? And we literally had to start from decluttering, because there's so much clutter outside. People are highly stimulated with so much information, so many claims, so many packs, 2x, 3x, 4x. And there is the whole core purpose of hair coloring, which is just saying that cover your grays. And if you go back and look at some of those branding and visuals, the way it's been done earlier.
How do you stand out in this clutter?
The stand out by simplifying the messaging and saying that it's very simple. I'm here there for you, and very easy to identify. So the kind of visuals you use is to make sure that people kind of can spot you in such busy clutter for the right reason, for the
but
right purpose.
But I see your Kareena Kapoor and Virat Kohli.
That's in the advertising. That's
yeah,
not on the back.
Advertising what goes to the people, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah, but it's also advertising is also consumed very now. Advertising is not.
Instead of
now.
Kareena Kapoor, you could have been the model.
Yeah.
How does it matter to me?
But see, if you see the packs, the models which should be used are all
how
Indian
much
models.
How much you have to say in the advertising when you are doing the packs?
We don't have much to say in the advertising,
that's
but we
wrong.
Definitely
we do.
But when it see, some of these calls are taken collectively and collaboratively, and a lot of these is based on data. And as designer, I don't think we can deny data and statistic. And I think it's only fair to go by the statistic, because that's what's going to give scale and that's what's going to make good products available to multiple people. And it's not that there have not been options, but if you see the digital platform today and brands like DeepLearn, where we spend disproportionate money on digital media than TV. Though TV was a smaller activation, that ad didn't kind of fly to the masses, it was only to a targeted audience. But most of it, what you see on Instagram blogs, is so, most of the content is consumer generated. And
but
all of these are Indian.
Your name sounds very Western, isn't it? Godrej.
Right. Godrej. Godrej is not Western.
I am saying that it's anything.
Yeah, Godrej is a family. Yeah.
I know that it's a family, Godrej and Boise. Boise was his partner.
Yeah.
And Boise did not come in the picture at all. Now it is just a Godrej.
Yeah.
But the point is, you have 1 billion consumer.
Right.
You know that. That's
right.
Now, I think you have a big export market.
Right.
Now, how do you stand in that market, even in Indian market, when you have Livers and other
right.
brand?
Yeah.
Because I see this package. That is, I think, most of the thing which I saw in your
entries. Yeah. But that, yeah.
Now, how could you say this is India? Don't you feel your responsibility as a designer take India to the world? Where? How are you taking that?
I mean, how do you define India now anymore, right? So
anymore?
In the sense, India is
70 years old.
Yeah.
Still, our currency just changed.
True.
And it has changed also, I think,
true.
Couple of times.
Yeah.
Now I don't know what is going to happen.
Yeah.
But it's changing.
Yeah.
So now the time when the country is saying make in India or made in India, this started actually 1977 by Mrs. Gandhi. She wanted to do leather product.
Yeah.
Because leather was
so let me I know what you're asking. I think we are in the day and age where world is becoming boundaryless, and there are more and more opportunities, and we are inspiring from Africa, Indonesia, Southeast Asia, Japan, Korea. Everything is coming together. Now India can say that I want to stereotype India and I want to impose what India is, and I have my own definition of India. India could be defined in so many different ways, right? There are so many musicians, artists, they're doing things which are of global standards. And what do you now call a global standard anymore? Everything is coming as a flat world, right? So our approach has been towards India is that while we look at the need of hair color, so we have hair color available in sachets at 30 rupees. We were the first one to to make a hair color cream available, when Garnier and L'Oreal were doing 500 rupees and they were using Aishwarya Rai and you're worth it kind of a campaign, we actually made that creme available in sachet. What we did in that is we actually not designed much. We said take out all the packaging, what people need is product, and we need to invest all that money into sensorial of the products and not the packaging and not the imagery and not the pictures. And we actually took out all the pictures from the pack and we said we need to be inclusive because it's a functional product. So you have, India is a very diverse country. You have consumers at the bottom of the pyramid, and which is the mass, and you have consumers aspiring to go to the fashion, who can afford more fashion, who can spend that much more money. As Godrej, we need to expand our footprint. We've always been serving the mass market and we've done that well, but we also need to take them to the next level with these two things, which is move them from powder kind of format to creme format and create that accessible price point with such a delightful product experience, and also create an accessible price point for a premium seeking consumer, premium experience seeking consumer who's not able to afford 500 rupee L'Oreal creme and enjoy hair color. What we did differently, and if you see the pack carefully and if you study the shades carefully, we say that these shades are designed for Indian hair colors. So you might see Kareena, and Kareena is very Indian. You look at Rajab, we met, you look at the way she portrays the youth and the persona and the energy of that young aspirational woman.
No, that's
really well.
The beginning I told you,
right.
That I don't care who is Kareena.
Right. It's about what personality she
presents. My question is how do you take India to the world?
It's not about the India, I think, because I work for Godrej and GCPL, it's about how can we take some of these good ethos and values and meaningful, purposeful products, which comes from a design thinking point of view, how can we take that value to the next level, right? And what we are doing exactly is what we have done over since 2007, what we have done here, it has given us immense credibility. People are asking for, products like roll-on or pockets or air freshener, and people are constantly asking for where this is coming from, and people are finding great value and happiness into that. What we at the end of the day want to see is people being, consumer being extremely delighted for the quality of the product and the way it feels and the way they interact. And I think with training of NID, with the training of design methodologies and tools, we ended up creating during this journey, and we didn't know it the first year. It happened over time and we evolved. And today I think we have a set template and we know and we are not ignorant about the fact, and I congratulate Tarun, who being a business, coming from business school, been able to talk design so flawlessly. And how can we do and multiply this kind of a culture we have created at GCPL in Africa and Indonesia, where we have acquired business.
But you saw that, bhujia,
right,
going all over the world.
Yeah.
It goes as a Indian product.
Yeah. So we are.
But how do we see the Godrej going? It's not a small company, it's
right.
Not a new company,
right.
It is 120 years old,
yeah,
company.
Yeah.
So it has its brand value.
So
I want to say
something here, and it comes from what we believe strongly at Godrej and in purpose, is that when I want to go to Africa, I don't want to be Godrej of India, I want to be Godrej of Africa. And the effort there is, we have been going there, traveling there since 2 years. I got really long braids done on my hair just to feel what they feel when they wear hair extensions, right? And we are into a very different category. We don't want to impose what we are in. We want to take values there. And these values are relevant no matter what brand you are, whether you're Unilever, P&G, Godrej. We believe that our values could be differentiated.
You don't believe the brand.
We do believe brand, but the brands we have, Godrej is a master brand, the brands we have under them are the brands we believe.